too much of it, it gets out of control. I don't think it's quite as systemic as we saw in the 1970s. But it really ought to be the Fed to do something. I think the Fed recognizes that.
Yeah, I realize it's nowhere near as bad as what we saw in the 1970s. I realize it's not double digit, but you do hear anecdotally so many stories about workers who are asking for raises and getting them. I just heard this morning of another story of a restaurant owner who had the dishwasher asking for a raise to $25 from 18, and he said, no, the guy left, and the owner's been washing dishes themselves for the cleaning himself for the last 3 weeks. You hear other stories about in California where families of medically fragile children can't find nurses, even though they've been authorized, medically authorized to have nursing care, particularly at night. They can't find anybody because the state's only paying $44 an hour for a nurse, and those people have all gotten stipend elsewhere. So these parents are staying up all night, not able to sleep to try and keep their children alive. I mean, there are some real world implications of what's happening right now, and it is showing up in wages.
Well, remember, we do have a very low unemployment rate, and the worker participation rate is increased, so it's hard to get people at lower wage levels to work. And I'm sure we're all having trouble doing that. Remember, we never did increase the minimum wage. Minimum wage is still relatively low in this country compared to other OECD countries. So I think it's not a surprise that wages have gone up, but I don't think it's going to be so systemic that you're going to see a sustained 7% inflation. I just think it'll come down to closer to 4 or 5% or so later this year, and hopefully get down to closer to 3 or 4% by the end of the year.
So if the market knows that this is coming, if this has been pretty well telegraphed and the Fed moves at an orderly pace, two questions. First of all, does the market react to any of these moves, or has it already done the reaction? We've seen a 10% cut for the NASDAQ. We've seen other stocks come back down significantly more. Is that enough? Is that a reflection of what you think is going to happen?
Well, the S&P 500 is trading at about a 23 times multiple. That's a little high when you get that tightening. Normally, the S&P 500 is probably on 17 or 18 times. When the markets tend to tighten, interest rates go up, you tend to see a much lower P ratio than you have at 23 now. So the market's still a little bit full, I would say, probably compared to where you are normally when markets are really tightening because interest rates are going up. So a slight correction from here wouldn't be unwarranted or wouldn't be impossible to see.
And I guess the second part of my question is that the Fed's also going to be tightening the balance sheet at the same time, and we've never seen a tightening like this. How will that play out? What will that change? What are the market implications of that?
Well, we had quantitative easing the first time in the Great Recession. The Fed ultimately did do a pretty good job of reducing its balance sheet. The balance sheet is much bigger than it was then, and so it's going to take a little bit longer to get the balance sheet reduced. But I think the markets anticipate this, and I don't think that's going to be as big a problem. I think the biggest problem is whether something comes that's unforeseen. If there's a war in Russia and Ukraine, if something happens in the Middle East, something happens in China or Taiwan, markets are expecting certain things to happen. And when there are geopolitical events that come along that we don't anticipate, that could mess up the markets much more than anything else we're likely to see.
I argue that the market is anticipating Russia doing something in Ukraine. That's why we've seen oil prices move so high so quickly.
I think the market is a little uncertain, as everybody is uncertain about what's going to happen in Ukraine. I think President Putin is looking for a way out, in my view. I don't really have any inside information. I suspect he would like to get off the precipice and find a place that he would do so. And I think the administration has done a pretty good job of figuring out ways to box him in a bit so that ultimately he looks for a place that he would like out. He won't be seeing a terrible loss. On the other hand, I think it's very important to say that the Soviet Union fell. Losing 25% of your market value one day is probably unusual. strong company, but that is probably an unusual loss. I do think that some of the biggest names probably have a little bit more air in them than probably might be expected at this time in the cycle. But I don't see any big gigantic market correction of the type that's going to push us into a recession. I don't see that at all. I think the market correction will be modest relative to what we've seen in the past when you have a gigantic correction.
What's been so interesting about this has been the strength of the consumer through this economy. If you listen to Bank of America yesterday, they talked about how people paid so much off on their credit cards during the fourth quarter, so much more than they had been a year ago or 2 years ago, even pre-pandemic levels. Just the strength of the consumer is almost at every level. And the money to spend from consumers and from businesses makes this time a little different. Is there any time that you want to go back to and say, this reminds me of X time?
Well, the consumers do have a fair amount of cash. I think they are paying down as you suggest. I don't think we have an over leveraged situation, which is what we had in the Great Recession. There was an enormous amount of personal credit in the recession of 2008 and 2009, and we don't see that right now. So I don't think it's a debt led problem that we have right now. I think right now we have a bit of a confidence problem. People are uncertain about the future. I think people are also a little uncertain about what exactly the Fed will do and exactly what the impact will be. But on the whole, I don't think the economy is in dire shape. I don't think anything like a recession is imminent. And so I think we'll have a little air out of the bubble, a little bit of a correction, but nothing that the body is really unduly nerve-wracking in my view.
David, we would decide. Thank you for your time, sir. It's good to see you.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.
Coming up, the Super Bowl is expected to smash gambling records. We'll tell you how much money is going to be on the line. Sunday, stay tuned. What is technical work from? The money market maker pays your broker to trade with your order at the price he decides. Your broker will charge you no commissions and leave you no choice. At Interactive Brokers, you do have a choice. You can choose to pay no commissions, just like in other brokers, or you can pay a small commission. And IBKR will try to match you up with an institutional order at a better price.
At Fidelity, your dedicated advisor will work with you on a comprehensive loan plan across your full financial picture, a plan of tax-free investment strategy designed to help you keep more of what you earn. Yes.
The presentation was okay, but the last slide you had, when companies work to make people's day, through anything that Chris Finkel saved us. You saw something. It changed everything. I don't think we don't see you, but I'm so glad you were the one in the room with him.
When people are recognized, they feel safe. They feel like they belong.
They do.
Because without the human, it's just work.
So my mom sent me early signs recently because I quit my job. Well, I was let go.
Express flowers delivered directly to your door with a push of a button.
My favorite person to send early stems to, easily, my mom.
My husband, Alex, supplied them all usually our bouquet of most of the flowers. Always in the case for flowers.
Getting married, getting promoted, having a baby, getting divorced, getting early stems. They are absolutely beautiful.
Just like you. Are you guys hiring?
With the best office for Super Bowl 56, DraftKings is going to make you feel like a champion.
Oh, yes.
Bet $5 to win 280 if your team wins Super Bowl 56. That's 56 to 1 out. DraftKings, an official sports betting partner of Super Bowl 56.
Jim.
Not the time, Jerry.
Not the time.
When it comes to investing, think in depth with intensity. Interpreting notes, finding patterns, and anticipating changes in market rhythms. Discover the difference intense research makes with Columbia Threadneedle Investments.
Well, that swap get all times here. They are sliding again in the pre-market this morning in the wake of a significant shake. The Peloton CEO John Foley is stepping down to be replaced by former Spotify CFO Larry McCarthy. The company is going to also be cutting 100 jobs. Also announced his quarterly results, which have been scheduled to be released this afternoon after market close. They pulled that out. Peloton lost $1.39 per share for its latest quarter. I almost had anticipated a loss of $1.21 per share. But if you call this company is going to be dressed up for sale, I'm not so sure. Looks like John Foley is very much going to stay around as the executive.
was to work with him. So we'll try to lead into more of this when we come back. SWAT returns after this.
Have you ever seen a stock that went through the roof? The button, only a new better? Well, get in the know and join the market team. Where every investor, just like you, can stock this from a team of market leading stock picks. Their average return is over 600%, more than four times the return of the S&P 500. Get stock picks every month at a special member price of just $79 for your first year. Don't look back and say, I wish I knew about that. Join at bull.com/79.
Cover it up. That's what I did when I started this night. And I realized I can actually do something. Now I use peaks, the easiest way to keep my head. And it only costs $1 a day, which means no more covering up. Get started at peaks.com. The same kind of real estate investments that have powered one of the strongest portfolios for decades are now available to you. The properties generating income today, the developments generating tomorrow. The power of real estate investing is now in the palm of your hand. Join the community of over 150,000 investors who are building a better portfolio with Fundrise today.
This is a Tony Box, a magical little speaker for kids. And this is a Tony. The Tonys are filled with stories and songs that come to life when you place one on the box. She loves it because she can use it all around. I love it because it entertains for hours without a screen. Together, we've been building up a collection of all her favorite characters. Every Tony is a different adventure and a new world for her to explore. Listen as the magic comes to life.
Millions, literally, of Americans are expected to place a wager of some type on the Super Bowl contestant Brewer. As you're going to tell us what has changed and the stakes continue to adopt and liberalize various sports gambling. I don't think it's legal yet online or California. Is it contestant?
It's not legal at the retail sports books in California, Joe, and that's a big problem for the state of California going into the Super Bowl. You know, we are likely to see an enormous spike in the number of people who bet on the big game this year, according to research just released this morning by the American Gaming Association. It predicts 31.4 million Americans will make a wager on the big game, up 35% from last year, and they'll bet an eye-popping $7.6 billion. 78% from last year. That dramatic rise attributed largely to broader access. Well, since last year, 10 states have launched legal sports betting, meaning 45 million more Americans can wager in their home state than last year. And in total, bettors can legally wager on the big game in 30 states plus Washington, D.C., with three more states having legalized it but not yet launched. One of those states, Ohio, home of the Super Bowl contender Cincinnati Bengals. So get this, fans in Ohio can root on their team, but they can't place a legal bet on them. That's okay, neither can California fans of the LA Rams or any of the spectators at the Super Bowl. Not legally. Research by sportsgamble.com suggests we'd see an additional $400 million wagered on the game this year if those two states had legal live digital betting. It also presumes 10 betting platforms, a game that's competitive till the fourth quarter, and no major technical glitches, which of course is what CZ, BetMGM, FanDuel, DraftKings, all the others are looking for too, Joe.
All right, Contessa. New Jersey, I'm good. I can do it. I can do it all the better. But that's the last sailing day we're going with, probably. Our next guest is a front row seat for what will be served at Super Bowl parties around the country on this Sunday. We'll
founder and CEO Joe Ariel joins us, and Super Bowl's great, and some specific events today, but in general, food e-commerce has flourished during the pandemic. I can't imagine it's going to continue to be this great, but 30% growth still expected per year for the next 3, 4, 5 years, right, Joe?
That's right. Why not? Food's a $1.7 trillion market. You know, people want convenience. People want experience. And I think, in regards to what we do, an emotional food experience. Right? Why is it in fashion, in travel, in gadgets, you can have the best stuff no matter where you live? We do the same for food. It's not about where you live. It's what you love. It's the foods that bring you happiness. And that's the business we're in.
Specifically mentioned, what are trash can nachos? Okay, it's got everything on them, mostly I'm already seeing connected to those. Like, are those going to be big this Sunday for Gold Bell?
You should, yeah. You would love trash can nachos. So, this is what I'm sharing, also known as the mayor of Flavortown, created this dish, which is like a mini trash can. Nachos, cheese, sour cream, jalapenos, guacamole, and you get to choose brisket, pulled pork, or beans on top. And it's all spring too. You have to shuffle out the can, and this pile of gorgeous nachos appears in the middle of your Super Bowl table. Oh, it's a good thing.
Yeah, you are making me emotional. I'm just feeling a little bit teary. You know, I thought about something. You know what the metaverse is never going to disrupt? Gold Bell.
Now all of a sudden, you can ship an order 3,000 miles. It's not about just food. who lives in your neighborhood, where you who you can reach on a local delivery platform, the entire country is a potential customer.
There's
Yeah, interest rates are rising. We have had this
you'll find that it will increase dramatically. I mean, very rapidly and by a very significant magnitude. And that's going to be associated with it, a new question of longer duration stocks, if you will. And that's very difficult. Other companies, as well as what we've indicated to do that the stock has acquired and then reorganized particularly the company that we took it. But the idea of many of those companies are rapidly growing, and some of them have rapid growth.
底下我他说唐总发表重要讲话 Thank you.